Whenever there's a world where it's possible for characters to have superhuman abilities, you will often find at least one instance of an individual having the ability to augment their own power. That is, to increase their own strength beyond the limits of what is normally possible for a human of that world. And the world of Ruby is certainly no different when it comes to superhuman abilities, with every individual having the potential to awaken their own semblance. And out of the semblances that we've already seen in the Ruby storyline, we've already had a number of them that fall into this category of power augmentation. We've seen Sienna Khan's grudge, that when her semblance is active, her power increases proportionally to the amount of aura that those around her have lost. We've also seen High Voltage, held by Nora Valkyrie, where she is able to absorb electrical energy into her body, channel it to her muscles, and thus increase her own power temporarily. But I've made videos on those two already, and today I want to talk about two seemingly very similar power augmentation style semblances. The semblance of Burn, held by Yang Xiaolong, and the semblance of Moonslice, held by Adam. They've been compared even within the Ruby series itself, as they rely on damage that an opponent would be dealing to the user. However, beyond that, the semblances operate very differently in their functionality and in the way even that they deal the damage back to opponents. With Yang's semblance of Burn, she takes the damage herself, physically reducing her aura as she's taking this damage, and then when she activates her semblance, she is able to deal that damage back double what it was that she took. Seems pretty straightforward. It creates an interesting dynamic between her absorbing enough energy to be able to deal that final blow and trying not to absorb too much energy so that her aura ends up breaking in the process. Though I do have to point out that in the Volume 5 Yang character short, it does seem like Yang's aura broke before she used her semblance. It flickered, and then the sound that accompanied it definitely sounded like an aura break. However, the Grimm that she was fighting, she was in the fangs of the Grimm at the time, it didn't just bite her right in half, so I'm questioning as to whether her aura entirely broke, because after that point, she increased her physical strength enough that when she went and punched the Grimm and clashed with it, that she literally just punched it with her own physical strength, not using Ember Celica, and the Grimm not only broke its arm, but also died afterwards. So her semblance was definitely active, but it seemed her aura was broken, and this is the only instance I've seen of that happening in the Ruby series, so I'm, you know, questioning some of the things with that, but still, the purpose of Yang's semblance is that she takes the damage herself, and she has to walk that fine line of taking enough damage to the point when she would be able to deal the damage back and not have her aura break. And then we get to Adam's semblance, one that I feel a lot of people are a bit confused on, as when he takes the damage himself, he doesn't have to take it physically. He blocks it with his sword, and therefore his semblance is reliant on his sword. But it's not, though. It's not relying on his sword specifically. Adam chooses to have it rely on his sword. The way that Adam's semblance works is that he absorbs the damage through his aura in a different way than Yang. Yang takes it through her physical aura cloak, whereas Adam takes the damage through things that he is using as a conduit for his aura. It's just the thing that he's most comfortable using is Wilt and Blush, his sword and sheath. And so he stores it within Wilt, the thing that he's using as a conduit for his aura, technically still storing it within his aura, and then is able to deal it back through that same conduit. Whereas Yang uses the power that is absorbed and increases her own physical strength, as well as being able to augment her own aura and the things that she's using as a conduit for her aura, because we've seen her activate her semblance and fire off a bullet from Ember Celica that is increasingly powerful. The fight with Mercury in specific, for in Volume 3, she was dealing a lot of damage to him, not just only in physical punches, but also through the shotgun blasts from Ember Celica, etc. Whereas Adam, all of this damage is focused into the blade itself, into the conduit that he's using, which is Wilt. And because of that, it allows him to have such devastating power, because all of that damage that for Yang, when she takes it, it is spread out throughout her entire body. For Adam, it is focused onto that blade, onto the sword's edge, if he so chooses, and thus allows him to deal such devastating blows as, absorbing an entire laser blast from a spider droid and then literally disintegrating it. also enough energy from a few bullets from Blake, as well as the other places he was fighting beforehand in Volume 3, so much so that he had enough power to slash through the remainder of Yang's aura and her arm along with it. That was really the only instance we've seen of someone's aura being broken and them being dealt serious physical damage at the same time, but that's just how strong Adam is. Because of the way he's able to absorb the damage and focus it into his blade, he is just that much more powerful, meaning that the damage that he is absorbing, seemingly to me, is not dealt back twice, but multiplied exponentially. So it's not just dealing back double the damage, but a lot more, because it is focused into that one weapon, into that one area of his blade. And then it gets to the other abilities that Adam was able to display. In particular, the energy blasts and afterimage techniques that Adam displayed in his fight against Blake and Yang at the end of Volume 6. Now, the energy blasts themselves are a simple release of the energy that Adam has stored up in Wilt. He's able to slam the blade in the ground and release the energy outwards. So it is different than Yang's, as she channels the energy inward to her own muscles, and when she's using her aura, she can power up Ember Celica and the blasts from it, so I don't know if she can actually channel it outwards similar to Adam, but since he's limited to his aura, he's just releasing a very strong aura blast outwards. And when it comes to the afterimage technique that he uses, where he can create physical afterimages, he's channeling the power that's stored up in Wilt to the rest of his body. And we actually see him do this when he's fighting against Blake and Yang. As he's gearing up to fight against Yang, we see Wilt glow red, and then it channels onto the red portions of his body, the red portions of his cloak, as well as his hair. It starts at Wilt and channels upwards. So he's spreading that energy across his entire body, and that's what allows him to make these physical afterimages. Whether that's something tied into his semblance specifically, or just an other added ability that maybe Yang could duplicate at some point, though I kind of doubt it, he's able to channel this across his entire body, and thus when he attacks, he's able to create these physical aura afterimages. But it's important to note that these are afterimages. This is not a separate clone-style semblance or anything like that. It's not the same as Blake or Sun. He needs to absorb this energy first, spread it and disperse it across his entire body, and then make these afterimages when he's attacking. Now, with that being the case, that draws into question, does this semblance have other capabilities beyond just normal power absorption and release? And unfortunately, we don't know. We may never know because, well, unfortunately, Adam's storyline has come to an end. Though we may see him again later on, and hopefully we will see him again in flashbacks, because there are still a couple things that need to be explained that I am looking forward to having explained at some point in the Ruby series. But this also opens up some potential for Yang's semblance and how it might evolve in the future. Because if Adam is able to absorb the damage into his aura and focus it to a single point, and Yang and Adam's semblances are supposed to be similar in that aspect, that they're absorbing the damage into their aura just in different ways and expelling the energy back outwards in different ways, then maybe Yang would be able to use this damage that she's absorbed and focus it to a single point. Like if she was able to focus it into a single fist, then she would be a lot stronger, because right now she is dispersing the entire power. Whenever she activates her entire semblance, she powers up her entire body, so she can do a flurry of blows and deal that damage double to her opponent over a number of blows. Whereas with Adam, he seems to very much favor the one-shot, one-kill approach, where he not only focuses all of that damage into a single point, being Wilt, but into a single strike. And this works very well with his fighting style of quickly drawing Wilt out from its sheath for one-shot attacks. And this makes him a very devastating opponent, able to end fights in a flash, as Yang has experienced firsthand. So if Yang is able to do something similar with her semblance, focus all of that damage that she's absorbed into a single point of her body, either a single punch, as I mentioned before, or even a single shot of Ember Celica, that would be something extremely devastating and something that could end fights in a single shot. And she also has that robotic arm now, so she'd be able to withstand the recoil from something like that, because even with aura, I would imagine that your bones would end up being cracked from experiencing that much force, but Still, that remains to be seen, but let me know what you guys think down in the comments below comparing Yang's and Adam's semblances. Do these comparisons and differences I've stated make sense? That, of course, Yang absorbing the damage with her body, Adam having to absorb the damage with his blade, we knew that already, but in the way that it actually operates, that Adam is using or absorbing the damage using conduits for his aura. It's not that he's limited to Wilt specifically, it's just that's what he chooses to. And then when he loses Wilt or loses the thing that he's using as a conduit for his aura, he no longer has anything to use his semblance with. Hence why at the end of that fight with Blake and Yang, when Wilt was thrown overboard, he was very desperate to get it back, because he needed it to activate his semblance, and he became very reliant on it for fighting. And then with Yang able to take the damage herself, of course, playing it very close to the edge, you know, whether her aura breaks or not, and let me know your thoughts on the Volume 5 Yang character short. Did her aura actually fully break, and then she activated her semblance? Because that would kind of break some of the rules that we already know, but let me know your thoughts on that. But do you think that Yang's semblance could evolve to the point, or she could figure out how to use it and have that much aura control where she could focus the damage that she's absorbed to make her single attacks that much stronger? I would love to know your thoughts on this down in the comments below. I have a couple other semblance breakdown videos that I'm planning, so if you enjoyed this video, want to see more like it, want to see more Ruby content, the Phoenix Festival Tournament, other OC storylines that I'm going through currently. Already Serafina Vermilion and Zelina Ray have been introduced to this YouTube channel, and their story is only just beginning. So hopefully you guys will look forward to that. Make sure to subscribe if you do want to see more. Join our Discord server, link in the description below. Tweet me at PhoenixKnight7, and I'll see you guys in the next video.